Hey everyone, today we're going to learn how to animate or adjust the cursor path inside of Camtasia 2023. So let's go ahead and get started. Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering anything learning development related. If you're new to the field or want to learn more about learning development, you can check out all those previous blog posts. You can also download free templates, and these are templates in Articulate Storyline 360 and XAPI and video templates. And then you can check out full courses. If any of these tools are new to you, you can check out full courses in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. Today we're going to learn about a feature that I think is pretty awesome inside of Camtasia 2023 and also 22, I believe, and I think 21 as well. But you're able to edit the cursor path. So if you've created a screen recording, and let's say you've been moving your mouse, and you don't want the learner to be distracted by your mouse movements, you can go ahead and change those inside of Camtasia. An incredible feature, which I think is one of the reasons why I'd want to use Camtasia over using something just like QuickTime or just a simple screen recording in Windows or something like that. So I want to walk you through how to do that. So in order to do this, I need to pull up my Camtasia project here. And in my Camtasia project, I have my course here. And you'll notice I have my screen recording, and you'll notice how my mouse starts to move. In order to adjust the cursor path, I have a couple different options. So I can select this and then go into my cursor over on the right-hand side. Now I could also adjust my cursor so it's a lot larger, so I can see, or the learner can see my wherever my mouse movements are a lot better. You can also adjust the transparency, opacity. If you wanted to smooth cursor across edits, that will make it a lot smoother. So it's not just jumping to different parts, especially if you make some edits, it's going to make it a lot smoother there. But then this is where you can go in and completely have full control over your mouse cursor. So if I click on edit cursor path, it's going to say simplify existing path. So it's going to convert everything that I have done already into an existing path. Now notice down at the bottom in my timeline, this is when I actually move my mouse. And so the first one goes from point A to point B pretty easily. So there's really not much that goes on there. And then I can scroll down and kind of go over. Well, I don't need to necessarily move over. So what I can do is take this keyframe right here. And notice how my icon actually changes. It'll let me know how the cursor will actually change between these different points. But I don't need this point B, so I can go ahead and just delete that and notice how it just moves over to the bottom right-hand side. Now, the reason why it's changing that cursor is because it notices, and this is in the web, it notices its text, and it's going to change it as though I want to select the text. I don't necessarily want that for a screen recording. So what I can do is come over here and just select this back to my normal. And by selecting it back to my normal, notice how it kind of changes in the middle there. Well, I can just go back to point A, and notice when I select point A, this is the part that it changes. So I can select that cursor right there. Let's come back into about there right here. Make sure that's highlighted in yellow here, and let's change that back to normal as well. So it will adjust and keep the cursor the same. So just all these full controls that I have over the cursor path makes Camtasia a lot more effective or better to work with in screen recordings. So let's come over here where I start to go crazy. I start to move my mouse. Now I could hold down the shift button and select several. Let me go back. So select several of these keyframes and then go ahead and hit delete. And now it's made this a lot better. And now it just kind of goes up like that. I can adjust this even more. But I can also come to my timeline and notice how it's like a Bezier curve. So I can click and drag and adjust how this actually curves out. So if I don't want this to curve out so drastically, let me select this again. I can grab these handlebars and adjust that curve. I can also take that and notice how it's kind of a sharp point where I come into here and then I move up. Well, if I wanted to round that out, I could actually even adjust that by clicking on these different options and different easing. Easing will make it so it starts to slow down when it gets to that point, or speed up after it goes away from that point. So that's your different easing options. We have in, out, and both. Full controls over the type of cursor that I can actually use as well. I can even bring in my own cursor. So a lot of different options to choose from. So you can adjust your cursor path. You can create a custom path. You can highlight different things. You can change the size of your cursor. So many different things that you can do with your cursor path that I wanted to show you here. If you wanted to learn more, head on over to my website and check out my blog post covering anything learning development related, Camtasia, Storyline, Articulate. You can also download free templates and Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI, and video templates. And if any of these tools are new to you and you wanted to learn everything from A to Z, you can get courses in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button, and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to grow and to create more videos for you as well. And also, if you want to see anything else, feel free to comment down below, "Hey Jeff, I wanted to see this," and I check those comments every week. And if you have any other suggestions, you can leave those comments down below as well. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.